This is a Halloween ride that they had at the Lake of the Ozark Off-Road Park, which is also known as the LOTO, L-O-T-O. This was our second time riding down here. They were having this Halloween ride, so we came down for something different. They were having a scavenger hunt where they set out some orange cones, which had numbers on them where you can win prizes. Each side-by-side is only allowed to get one, so we were going to go on a group ride at 10 o'clock, so we had a little time, so we went out to do a little ride and kind of look and see if we could find one of the cones. Well, my wife does spot one, and
see, this looks really steep.
We found it pretty quick. Yeah, we went a little over a mile, and we found one. We thought, we'll see a whole bunch of these cones, because they put out over 20 cones, and we never saw another one after we found this one. Startled me when she started yelling, you know. I thought I was about ready to run into somebody. But, found the cone. It had number 12 on it, so later in the day they give out the prizes, and she won a cube spotlight. Had like a 3-inch cube spotlight, and one free day pass for down there, so it's pretty nice.
You want to just put it in the box?
But yeah, we figured, we'll see all kinds of cones, because we were out there.
Well,
not very many people had been riding.
We're down looking for cones now.
We never saw another one. We rode a little bit, and then we headed back to, because we wanted to go on the day ride. They were having a group ride. I was hoping that maybe they would take us some places that we hadn't rode.
On the rocks.
Pretty much everywhere they went, we had already rode before while we were down there. But it was fun. It was different. I've never been in a big group ride. This is where we started on the group ride. And I'm not sure just how many people they had, but they had, I know, over 20 that was in this group ride. They had a big turnout down there for this event. When you got a big group like this, it's pretty slow going. He took us down into a creek bed that water in it, and everybody lined up for a picture down in it. This is the owner's wife sitting here just taking pictures of everybody going by. But there was just about every kind of side-by-side made there, all different types and brands. And four-seaters, two-seaters. There was even an Arctic Cat there. You don't see very many of them around. You had Honda Talons, Kawasaki, Can-Ams, Polaris's.
I don't know how they're going to get them all down in there, because there's a bunch.
Here's a picture of them all lined up, and this wasn't even everybody because there were still people coming down the trail. That the red Honda Talon there, that's the owner. He was leading the group. And somehow we went from being fourth or fifth in line to mid-pack, but see all the different types of side-by-sides. There's a lot of four-seaters, kind of. Spot here.
Don't mind me videoing you, do you?
Oh, it's a hot spot.
I might get hung up on that.
Yeah, we're not high enough clearance.
Yeah,
we're gonna wait.
You're gonna wait. Yeah, you're a little long there. You're center of.
I don't have the wheels.
Well, we were out here the time before. My wife was a little nervous about that there. Now, this time she wanted to drive up it, so that's her driving up it.
Gas it.
And it did it.
There you go.
When you look at it, it looks kind of bad in person, but it stepped real nice and went right up it. We rode around some more, and then we came up to where somebody had flipped a four-seater over backwards up against a tree on the side of the hill there. we stayed there and watched it. They were trying to get it flipped back over. They got the straps to it, pulling on. There it is there. Boom, falls over on its side. They do get it pulled around, and they get it pulled back on its wheels, and they're able to roll it back off the hill. And surprisingly, I looked at it from, and I didn't get real close to it. It didn't look like it had too much damage to it. Now, they had trouble getting it started. They worked on it for a long time, and it smoked bad, but they finally got it going. They went out trail riding with it. And they had a group night ride, and we went on it. And I didn't show it, but they had like a haunted house. Well, it was actually a haunted barn. And we went through that, and then they started the group ride from there. So I didn't put much of the group ride at night. Video just isn't too good. I didn't have my light bar on the roof on it because I wanted to blind the guy in front of me. It was just a short night ride, but it's fun riding at night. At it shows if he's stopped or if he's moving. Or
are you guys gonna head home or stick around for the bonfire thing?
If that's the end of the ride, I might run down to the creek, clean up a little bit, and go home.
Yeah, we were gonna, got a pretty good drive to get home, so we just went down and drove through the creek a little bit there, knock off the big mud, went back and loaded up and went home. It was a good event. It was something different. The people down there are really nice people and friendly. And I mean, they were right up there helping get that guy off the hill, flipped over. But we had a good time, and give this place a try, because if he gets enough, he could get another 600 acres, and that'd be great. Good ride.